Hello student, my name is Shweta Patel, working as a lecturer in BPMP Polytechnic Gandhinagar. Today my topic is structure of Java program. This is a part of unit 1. Unit name is introduction to Java. The main objective of this session is basic structure of Java program. It is necessary to know that the structure of Java program and this session contains a detailed description of it. This session is essential for you before to learn more advanced lesson of Java programming. Here, in this chapter, you will study the structure of the Java program, such as how to create a simple Java program and what its different sections mean. This is the basic structure of Java program. It contains main 6 sections like documentation section, package statement, import statement, interface statement, class definition, and main method class. Now, we will discuss all the sections with the example. The first section is a documentation section. This section contains a set of comment lines giving the name of the program, author, and other details. Which the programmer would like to refer to at the large stage. You can write a comment in this section. Comments are beneficial for the programmer because they help them understand the code. These are optional, but we suggest you to use them because they are useful to understand the operation of the program. So you must write comment within the program. The comment in a Java can be used to provide the information about the variable, method, class, or any other statement. Java provides 3 types of comment line: single comment line, multi-line comment line, and documentation line. The next section is package statement. You can create a package with any name. A package is a group of classes that are defined by a name. That is, if you want to declare a many classes within a one element, then you can create a package. The statement declare as a package name and inform the compiler that the classes defined here belong to this package. It is an optional part of the program. That means if you don't want to declare any package, then there will be no problem with it and you will not get any errors. The package is a keyword that tells the compiler that package has been created. It is declared as package student. Package keyword is used to create a package. See the example package student. Here package is a keyword and student is the name of the package. The next section is import statement. Many predefined classes are stored in the package in a Java. An import statement is used to refer to the classes stored in other packages. After package statement, we can declare or we can use import statement. This is similar to hash include statement in a Java. An import statement is always written after the package statement, but it is a use or it is declared before any class declaration. We can import a specific class or classes in an import statement. Take one example like import package name dot class name. Suppose I want to use the test name class, which is included in the package student. So we can write here import student.test, where test is a class, student is a package. This statement instructs the interpreter to load the test class contained in the package student. Now, using an import statement, we can access to a classes that are a part of other name packages. Our next section is interface. This section is used to specify an interface in a Java. It is an optional section. Interface is a similar to a class, but it includes a group of method declaration. An interface is a lot similar to a class in a Java, but it contains only a constant and method declaration. Java directly does not support multiple inheritance. Suppose you want to implement the multiple inheritance in a Java, then we have to compulsory use interface statement. Now, our next topic is a class definition. A Java program may contain a multiple class definition. That means in a Java program, a single program may contain a multiple classes like class A, class B, class C, class D, etc. Classes are the primary and essential elements of a Java program. Java is a pure object-oriented language. That's why without class and object, we can't do anything in a Java. The number of classes used depend on the complexity of the problem. Now, the next topic is main method class. Every Java standalone program required a main method as a starting point of the program. This is an essential part of the Java program. There may be many classes in a Java program, but only one class defines the main method. Main method create an object of various classes and create a communication between them. Methods contain data types, declaration, and executable statements. Now, our next topic is simple Java program. Now, I will discuss this program with each by each statement. Like this, the first line in this program is a class state. Here, we have created one class. The class name is a taste. Class is a keyword and it declares that a new class definition. Taste is a name of the class, or we can say that it is a Java identifier which is used to specify the name of class. Second line is a opening braces. In a third line, we have to write here public static void main string args. Now, what is a public? Public is the keyword, or we can say that public is the access specifier. It declares main method as a unprotected. It means method accessible to all other classes. Static. It is a keyword which declares method is for entire class and not a part of any object of a class. The main method must be declared as a static because interpreter use this method before any object created. Next is a void. Void means it does not return anything. Then next is a string. String is a class in a Java. String args declare parameter name as a args which contain an array of object of class type string. Then the next statement is a system.out.println. This is a similar to printf in a C and cout in a C++. Since Java is a true object-oriented language, every method must be a part of an object. Println method always append a new line character to end the string. Here, println method is a member of out object, which is a data member of system class. And at the last, semicolon. Every Java statement must be end with the semicolon. And the last line is closing braces. This indicates the end of the program. When we create the Java program and when we save the Java program with a .java extension, we have must give the name, class name as a file name. Thank you.